Noise pollution can reduce our quality of life and even our life expectancy, causing an estimated 12,000 premature deaths in Europe each year. Noise cancellation devices often rely on destructive interference, where sound waves are combined so that they cancel each other out. The way waves add together depends on how they are aligned. If a second wave is shifted by half a wavelength compared to the first, the crests and troughs line up and cancel. Engine noise can be reduced in this way using a device called a quarter wavelength resonator. This is a side branch in a duct whose length is exactly one quarter of the wavelength of the noise we want to cancel. Part of the sound wave enters the side branch, is reflected and combines with the undiverted wave. The diverted wave has travelled an additional one half wavelength, so the waves recombine destructively, cancelling the noise. But there is a problem. Low frequency noises can have very long wavelengths, up to 17 meters, so the size of the resonator needed soon becomes impractically large. We use mathematical modeling to design special materials called acoustic metamaterials that can help us overcome this problem. Metamaterials have properties that are not found in conventional materials. Acoustic metamaterials have geometries that allow the manipulation of sound waves. Our metamaterial contains rows of ellipses and reduces the effective speed of sound in air by half. Crucially, it does this while closely matching the acoustic impedance of air. Impedance is a measure of how easily sound travels through a substance. When sound passes between materials with different impedance, some of the sound is not transmitted. For the resonator to work effectively, we need efficient transmission of sound energy along the side branch, so our metamaterial needs to have an impedance close to that of air. In experiments, a resonator made of our metamaterial reduces noise at half the frequency compared to a conventional resonator at the same size. So we can use a smaller resonator to reduce noise at a given frequency. This is because the speed of sound is equal to the wavelength multiplied by the frequency. When the speed of sound is reduced, either the resonator's length or the frequency of the sound can be reduced by the same factor. This permits the use of smaller resonators and creates possibilities for more practical devices to reduce low frequency noise.